Yo guys, welcome back to the channel. Your boy Bashiro here. So in this video, I want to talk about one of Ram Lethal's best moves, in my opinion, which is the Aggresso Ordono. I think that's what is it called, which is basically the jump 214 slash. I feel like this move is severely underrated, and for me personally, I haven't been using it maybe much during my gameplay, but I feel like after I've loved this move all night, I've came up with really, really interesting usages for this move, and I feel like hopefully this video will help you change your mind, like that you will go more for it. So guys, as usual, support your boy Bashiro. Thank you so much for your support. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like. If you're enjoying the content, please consider subscribing. And if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below, and I will make sure to do my best to answer any questions. All right, let's begin. So how do you execute this move? Basically, when you jump and you do quarter circle backslash, or what we call 214 slash, this move is tiger kneeable. So what does tiger knee means? Tiger knee, it means that when you can like do a move as soon as you leave the ground, and there is like an input that you can do, like from back, quarter circle back, then you end it with a jump, then you cancel the jump with a special move. This means that the move will come out as soon as you jump, and this really brings out the potential of this move. So I'll slow down the inputs for you. Just keep in mind on the left section of the screen the input history, just to show you how it's done. So if I jump normally, this is how it looks like. If I tiger knee it, as you can see, the trajectory is different. So why this is good? Because this move, if you tiger knee it, it can hit actually crouching opponent. So even if you jump cancel it, it can still hit your opponent. So this is why this move is really, really nice. This move, when you have both of your swords equipped, it will do a two attack with the swords. It has great range, as you can see, and actually it can hit really, really low off the ground. When you lose your swords, this move becomes severely bad, and you should not use it if you don't have both of your swords. If you don't have your heavy slash sword, it means that you have your slash sword. When you do the move, still the first attack will come out, and I feel like still the move is really useful, even if you don't have like your heavy slash sword. So as you can see, it still hits low. I feel like if you lose your slash sword, then you should not go for it, because the move becomes severely like limited. So are the properties of this move? As I said, long range, good hitbox, and actually it can lead also to hard knockdown if used in combos. Let's do like a simple combo, something like that. As you can see, the opponent is hard knockdown. They cannot get up like quick get up or markers and front. So this leads like to some interesting setups in the mid screen, even in the corner, I believe. I'm not using this a lot in the corner, to be honest, but let's see. Yeah, as you can see. So what are the uses that you can use for this move, actually? The first thing, actually, is you can use it in neutral, and I feel like this is like the most straightforward use for this move. So for example, if you're jumping like something like that with slash, you can do it. Make sure always when you're pressuring with this move, like in the mid screen or you're playing in the neutral, make sure that both hits will hit, because if one hit, like the first hit it and the second one doesn't come out, there's landing recovery in this game, so your opponent can actually go for a punish, since the second sword attack did not come out. Because as you can see, when you land, like for example with the first move, see, as you can see, there's like a whiffed animation. So as you can see, so you need to do it like really, really low, like low enough off the ground so both hits will attack. You can also do it like, for example, from mid-screen interactions. So let's say you jump, you do have a slash. As you can see, this gives you like good spacing. So I feel like this is the most common use, and for conversions, I feel like it's a little bit hard to convert with this move, but I feel like it's really good, like just to pressure, to put distance between you and the opponent, and let them respect your range, actually, especially in the air. So I feel like this is the most straightforward use, and like I feel like this is what most people are doing with it. The second use actually is in combos. I feel like the use on combos for this, like for this move in particular, it's only useful if you're gonna secure like a hard knockdown, and you have like setup in your mind that you need to do it. Otherwise, there are more optimal combos that you can do, like both with meter and without meter. So I don't feel like this is really an effective like combo move, for example. But as I said, since it secures a hard knockdown after some combos, you can actually go for a jump or a safe move or etc. But personally, I haven't lapped those myself, so I cannot really like, I don't know 100% like what it can lead out of it, you know? Even if you have RC actually, which I will cover later in another section, there are better combos that can you can do actually, especially in the mid screen. You know, just to extend your combos. Since you have RC meter, you're very free to do whatever you want. Yeah. So I feel like the strength of this move lies in pressure and in mix-up. Because I feel like there's some really nasty things you can do with this move. And I will show you actually like a true 50-50 that you can pull off with that move. The nice thing about this move, it solves a big problem in Romlithal's pressure, especially in the mid-screen and in the corner. And is that 5K doesn't hit crouching opponents. However, this move, it will hit crouching opponents. Even though Jump K is a 7-frame startup attack, and it can hit like if you force phase situation, this move is still 12 frames, which is still relatively fast. So, for example, if I do this, this will land. However, if the opponent is crouching and I try to do this, as you can see, it doesn't land. The nice thing about this move, as you can see, it can hit the opponent. And the real strength of this move is when you have RC. So go for this move if you have RC. And now I will show you some applications that you can do. So let's put Sol in the corner and let's leave him crouching. The thing in this move, since it is an aerial move, you can jump cancel it out of a kick and out of a close slash. If you do it out of a kick, it's not a true block string. It means that your opponent can interrupt it. So this both has advantages and disadvantages. The advantage is that if you do that, it can act as a, what they call it, as a frame trap to punish your opponents who are mashing. But for example, if you're playing against an opponent like Sol, who has like amazing broken normals, he can interrupt it, for example, with a punch. So if I do this, as you can see, it's interruptible. However, if you know like you're facing that kind of opponent, what you can do is you can like delay the move itself in the air just to catch them trying to punish you. So something like that. As you can see, and you can go for a punish. However, if you cancel it out of a slash, it's a true block thing. It means that your opponent cannot really interrupt it. But I feel like you really need to practice the timing itself because the timing is a bit tight. So as you can see, something like that. And you need to perfect your tiger knee motion. Just keep something in mind, like if your opponent has a far-reaching normal and you're trying to do this move actually without, like for example, using RC meter, this move is very punishable since there is landing recovery. So for example, we'll do Sol. After block, he will do the 6 slash, which is like his longest range normal. And I feel like it's not the fastest thing in the world. So you can see, like, this is not really safe. That's why you need to rely on RC meter for that move. If you know that your opponents don't have the longest range of normals, you can actually just abuse it in meterless pressure. As you can see, it still comes out as a punish. So be wary of that. Let's now show you just some examples how you can use it actually in pressure. So for pressure, actually, what you need to do is you need to do either slash or kick, cancel it, and go either for a red Roman cancel or a purple Roman cancel. Red Roman cancel is relatively easy because basically you do this immediately after the move come out, then you can go for pressure. However, if you want to do the purple Roman cancel, you have to wait for the first attack animation to done, then you need to do it. Because if you do it immediately, like on your opponent, it will become bad. However, if you do this like that, sorry, and you still have enough time to pressure. Now let's show some pressure scenarios with RC meter, and after the pressure scenarios, I'll show you how you can convert out of it. Of course, as usual, I'll be leaving the timestamps below. So as you can see, the nice thing about this move, it's very hit confirmable. it means that depending on your C, like your opponent block it or they get hit by it, like as a frame trap, you can actually go either for a combo or for like okay or mix-up situation. Keep something in mind. This move is not an overhead. It means that your opponent can block it while crouching. So it's like when you do it, it is not the mix. It is what you do after it. All right. So it's not like jumping K where it's actually an overhead or jumping slash or jumping heavy slash actually. So even though it's fast enough, it's still a move that is not hitting the head of the opponent, but it's a setup move. So don't use it like, oh my God, like my opponent's crouching. I'm gonna overhead him with this attack. This won't work. Yani, unfortunately, this is one of the weaknesses of the move. So the final usage actually of this move in the mid screen is actually for 50-50 mix-ups. Believe it or not, this move has some really amazing applications in mid screen, especially if you're brave enough. Because the thing is, you need to this move really, really, you need to do it like really, really close to your opponent in order to set up your okay. So we'll slow it down. So I'll show you three different options. Keep something in mind. This move is actually like a jump attack. It means that it can beat throw. So we'll put, for example, your opponent after the knockdown, for example, just to do a throw. Sorry. As you can see, so your opponent cannot really jump out of it, but of course they can do DP and those things. Yani. So for now, let's just show some scenarios. And of course, we've set the opponent just to block the first attack, just to show you what happens. And I'll do some slowdowns in editing, so you can see like exactly how this move works. So as you can see, this move is nasty. I feel like I'm still loving like countermeasures, and I want to try it like in actual matches. But I feel like it's a airtight move, especially if your opponent is not doing something on the wake up, or they're really respecting your okay options. Because if you try to do it in the mid screen like that, like the corner things, it doesn't really lead into anything. So even if you do like that, you cannot really mix them up like if you do it raw. And it's on really, really low off the ground, because this moves actually, they push your opponent away. So you cannot really like execute this mix up. So yeah, guys, that's it. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Tag me on Twitter if you find some really nice setups with this move actually, so I can retweet your videos and etc. I'm really happy to see people like, yo, this tech is like that, you know, and then you're tagging me and then everyone can see. This makes me really happy. As always, thank you so much for watching and for your continuous support, and I'll catch you in the next video. Yalla, this is your boy Bashiro. Peace.